We want to evaluate this inverse trig expression in both degrees and radians. We have inverse cosecant of -2√3 divided by 3. This expression will equal some angle theta that has a cosecant function value of -2√3/3. But there's actually an infinite number of angles that would have this cosecant function value, and that's why it's important that we know the output or the range of the inverse cosecant function. This angle theta has to be in the open interval from -π/2 to π/2 if it's in radians, or if it's in degrees, theta must be on the open interval from -90° to +90°. So it's important that we know the range or the output of our inverse trig function values. So again, this is telling us that cosecant theta is equal to -2√3/3. Now it's difficult to recognize what common angle would have this cosecant function value. So if we can make the connection that cosecant theta and sine theta are reciprocals of one another, it'll be helpful to evaluate this. Again, if cosecant theta is equal to the ratio of the length of the hypotenuse to the length of the opposite side, remember sine theta is equal to the length of the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse. So the reason this is helpful is if cosecant theta is equal to this function value, then sine theta is equal to the reciprocal function value, or -3/2√3. And now if we rationalize this, we should recognize this sine function value. So now we'll multiply both the numerator and denominator by √3. So here we'll have 3√3. The denominator is going to be 6 because √3 times √3 is 3. 3 times 2 is 6. Notice how here we have a common factor of 3. This simplifies to 1. This simplifies to 2. So now we know that sine theta is equal to -√3/2. Now if we ignore the negative for a moment, having a sine function value of √3/2 should remind us of the 30-60-90 reference triangle. So if this is 30° and this is 60°, and this is a right triangle, remember we can label the short leg 1, the hypotenuse 2, and the longer leg √3. So notice how a 60° angle has a sine function value of √3/2. So even though we have sine theta equals -√3/2, this is telling us that we have a 60° reference triangle. And now if we go to the coordinate plane and identify the output of inverse cosecant, remember the initial side would be along the positive x-axis, and then the terminal side will be either in this first quadrant from here to here, or the fourth quadrant from here to here. Again, because of the range of inverse cosecant. So we can't draw a 60° reference angle in the first quadrant because that would give us a sine function value of +√3/2. So that means our 60° reference angle must be in the fourth quadrant, and it would look something like this. Again, where if we sketch the reference triangle, this would be 1, this would be 2, but because we're in the fourth quadrant, this would be -√3. So this is telling us that theta is equal to -60°, or in radians, we would have -π/3 radians. Okay, I hope this explanation helps.